What is going on, Guardians, and welcome back to another Destiny 2 video. In this video, we're going to talk about hand cannons and their specific role and strengths in the PvP arena in Destiny 2. I've seen a lot of feedback from the community on hand cannons and how they perform. So here's some of my thoughts and advice on how you can leverage their strengths in order to experience success. Now, one thing you have to keep in mind is that we have some preconceived notions about hand cannons from Destiny 1. I want you to wipe those clean from your brain. Just delete everything you know about hand cannons from Destiny 1. In D1, hand cannons were, from start to finish, across a few years, the undisputed champions of the Crucible. There were other guns that had a rise and fall in popularity, but hand cannons were always the kings. They had the greatest damage potential, the shortest time to kill, the greatest ease of use, and no real drawbacks in the range department until just at the end of Destiny 1, but even then the top players were still dominating with hand cannons. Every competitive event ever hosted in the D1 community was completely void of diversity in the primary weapon department. It was hand cannon, hand cannon, hand cannon. Now, delete that from your brain. In Destiny 2, diversity is much more prevalent because there is significantly more weapon balance across the board. So every weapon type has its strengths, its weaknesses. They are designed with specific uses in mind and specific scenarios where they work best. So the key is knowing when to pull out your hand cannon and when to put it away. What range, what environment, what movement to couple with it. Hand cannons have massive damage potential. With the most common archetype doing 60 to the head and others doing up to 80, it's not going to take long to put a target down if you hit your shots. In fact, standing toe-to-toe with a Uriel's Gift or a Prosecutor or a Mida, most hand cannons have the potential to kill faster. But it's a gambler's gun. That time to kill gets significantly longer with each shot missed. So how do you maximize your potential to do all your potential damage without taking the most damage from your opponent? That's the key question here. So let's talk about the strengths of the hand cannon. Now, first and foremost, you have to consider the fact that the hand cannons have a lot of mobility options. They have excellent aerial accuracy, rivaled only by sidearms. So good luck landing consecutive shots from the air with a Mida or a Uriel's Gift. Those guns are phenomenal in open combat with your boots planted firmly on the ground. They have a certain approachability that makes them very easy for the common gamer to use. Stand and deliver. Not much thought has to go into using them, but if you carbon copy that playstyle and transfer it over to a hand cannon, you won't experience as much success. So people go back to what's easy. But what's easy isn't always what's best, or it's not always the only viable option. Apply a little bit of thought to your movement, and you can be a lethal killing machine with a hand cannon too. By jumping around a corner, you can get the first shot from the air on your target, maybe do 60 damage to them, since their hitbox is limited more to just their head when you're above them. And by the time they set their sights on you, you can be ahead in the firefight by as low as 40 or as high as 120 damage. Hand cannons also couple exceptionally well with hunter movement. Hunters have some of the best mobility in the game with their superior PvP jumping and the addition of Shade Step or Gambler's Dodge. You can tag an opponent, dodge to cover, peek out, and continue firing. The next major strength of the hand cannon is the one that I really want to focus on, because it's honestly the core skill to have when using a hand cannon that leads to more successful engagements. Hand cannons, by design, are made for guerrilla-style combat. Big damage, short amount of time. Hand cannons work best when you take a shot, duck for cover, peek back out, take a shot or two, duck for cover, peek back out, and mop up the kill. Here's the thing, in the 1 second that you're exposed, you're going to get one shot off. Now, say since it's the opening shot, which gives you solid accuracy, since hand cannons have high initial accuracy that tapers off as you take consecutive shots, since it's the opening shot, it's likely going to hit. You do 60 damage in 1 second. Now, your opponent, using Uriel's, is only able to get two bullets into you in that 1 second. Doesn't have time to continue putting in consecutive shots in you. So you took, say, 30 damage, and you dealt 60, because you peeked out, took a shot, and went back to cover. He gets two bullets in you, you get one bullet in him, but your bullet did 60 damage, and his bullets did, say, 30 damage. So you're way ahead in the engagement now. 60 to 30. Then you peek back out. Your initial accuracy has reset by now. And you take another shot, dealing another 40 to 60 damage. He returns, say, 30 more damage or so. Now you're ahead fourfold. The key is taking that time where you're pulling in the recoil of the gun and waiting in between bullets that you can fire due to the rate of fire of the gun. You're taking that time and saying, hey, if I can't damage you during that time, then I'm not going to let you damage me. An AR is able to outgun you not because it does more damage per bullet, it's that there's no break in the stream of bullets. You're deciding to give them a break in their stream of bullets by disengaging for a second or two. That way, you stay on top of the engagement because you're doing more damage than they can return in short 1 to 2 second gunfights. You follow me? So, once you learn to couple movement and cover, you can make some downright nasty plays with hand cannons. Also, because of their high damage potential and a single bullet, they make great cleanup weapons. So you toss a grenade, swoop in, and mop up the kill in just 1 or 2 bullets. So, which hand cannons should you keep an eye out for? Here are my recommendations. Keep your eye out for an annual skate, minuet, better devils, judgment, the trials hand cannon, old fashioned, and even bad news, which shoots slower but has the potential to 3-tap and has the moving target perk for some added aim assist in combat. And remember that hand cannons do actually have some solid range to them. You can do 50 to 60 damage to the head at some considerable ranges. Now, I hope these tips have been helpful. Personally, I love using hand cannons in D2 and have experienced some great hero moments while wielding them. Use your cover, use your mobility, play to the strengths of the hand cannon, and you'll see the rewards starting to trickle in. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in a Crucible.